how old were you when you started DJing and producing?
I started producing when I was 15. I had my first record out when I was 15. And then I started DJing around 19.
So production was first?
Yeah.
Most people go the other way around.
Yeah, I mean, my whole family, we're all music freaks, so.
Of course, well, you've got Jesper as well, who's John's brother, who they do Hug and Pep, which is a production duo.
Yeah.
So you started producing at 15. What did you produce on then? And have you stayed on the same thing, or have you?
No, I was doing more like deep house and jazz influenced music, and then I changed to techno, and now I'm more housey kind of thing.
So were your parents then both musical as well?
Yeah.
Where came from?
Yeah, my father is he's in a jazz band and an old like progressive rock band, and my mom is.
Techno's a little bit different, so now you've gone more on a housey vibe. A lot of changes in the music industry recently. A lot of techno DJs are going a bit housier, and people sort of, there's a certain sound around at the moment. Where's your sound at right now?
I like to not only play house or techno. I mean, I always love to play all sort of electronic music when I'm playing.
Yeah, same.
And I think everyone does that at the moment. It's not clear genres anymore, it's more a mix.
When did Picadol start off?
We started off in 2001, I believe, or 2003 maybe. But Picadol is not actually working anymore. I just gonna start a new one together with the factory called Newton. I've been slow on Picadol for a while. I decided to do a fresh start.
So what's the new label?
Mutant.
Are you doing that by yourself? Or?
Yeah.
Okay, so when can we expect that to come around and what sort of sound is that going to be?
It's going to be in the vibes of Picadol, you know, something a bit different. And, you know, something has to be different with the music. It can't be even though I love like tech house, but it can't be totally flat. It has to have something.
The next upcoming month, I remember that you've got an album coming out.
Yeah, in September. So we're gonna do a few singles now, and I'm gonna go off to US in a couple of weeks, and then.
Are you going to the Miami Music Media Conference?
I'm not.
No, I was supposed to go. I'm not going yet. Have you played there before? Because as far as I'm aware, there's not really much of a scope for electronic music in America. Like. I have friends that have been like Matt Holmgren and people like that, and there are little pockets, but there's not really any. I mean, did you have a following there, or?
I mean, it's starting to get more and more. I have been in Miami playing, but not at the conference. And I think US is getting quite good now. Last time I was there in a couple of weeks ago, it was really good.
But the album out in September, is that finished and done now?
Almost, yeah.
Okay, so a bit of touring to promote the album?
Yeah, it's going to be, somebody's going to be busy with festivals, and then I'm going to promote the album.
So do you get any downtime at all, or are you just studio all the time?
I'm studio all the time, I guess. I love going there, and I produce. Sometimes I just go and produce something for my iPod, you know, something ambient or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Do you ever use instruments and stuff, or is it all programs?
Yeah, pianos and guitars and drums.
So what did you say you produced then?
I work on a PC with Cubase. But sometimes I go to my brother, who is a pop producer, and I record like real drums and pianos.
Is this a different world to Jesper, or is this Jesper?
No, Jesper's my cousin, and my brother's called Andreas, and he's producing pop in Sweden.
Oh, brilliant, definitely a musical family there.